everyone, I'm Michelle and welcome back to my channel. I'm going to be sharing what I got out of this book, the 100 Days of Inspiration, the Trim Healthy Mama book. And this week I did week 61 to 67. So there were a couple of things that stood out to me. I'm going to share the ones that, I don't know, encouraged me or just inspired me or stood out to me. And the first one is on day 65, and it is from Pearl and Serene, and it's talking about butter is rich in antioxidants and boosts high amounts of beta carotene and selenium, which shield the body from free radical damage. It is rich in iodine and then is essential to thyroid health and protective of breast and ovarian cancers. It contains a readily absorbable form of vitamin A. It is an excellent source of vitamin D, which maintains strong bones and lowers the risk of heart disease and osteoporosis. So, it says, for your health, toss your broccoli and butter and sea salt at dinner tonight. Yum. And I just thought this was interesting. I don't eat a lot of butter. I'm more of a coconut oil girl. And I actually have raw butter, so it's not like I have an excuse to not have good butter. And I grew up with butter, but I just don't. But maybe I should consider using more butter. I just thought that was interesting that it had vitamin D and iodine, and I just didn't know all that. So I thought that was interesting, and I wanted to pass that on. The next one is also from Serene and Pearl, and it talks about lamb. I don't know about you. I think I've probably had lamb once in my life, but I'm going to read to you what they were talking about lamb, like what's in lamb. So I'm thinking, I think I might need some lamb, as in I want to get a lamb and eat it kind of thing. I can't afford to go buy it, but when I... Hopefully we can add something like that to our homestead or whatever you want to call it. So, for example, lamb is one of the fattiest of all red meats. I didn't know that, did you? God told the Israelites to eat a whole lamb on the night of the Passover. Obviously, that was a spiritual lesson first and foremost, but also is practical. Lamb is high in vitamin B12. Did you know that? Because I didn't. Which supports red blood cell production and allows nerves to function properly. It is high in zinc, a mineral critical to immune function and wound healing. It is also a sort of carnosine, which is good for the heart. Goodness, I didn't grow up on lamb, so I didn't realize it had so many things in it, did you? It's like, I think I need to start eating lamb. But I always think of lamb chops. I think there's ground lamb too, isn't there? I wonder how it... Like, if it tastes different than beef does, because I kind of grew up on beef, so. All right, and then another one is day 63. I think the other one was day, let's see. Forgot to tell you what day that was. The other one was day 66, and this one's day 63. And again, it's Pearl and Serene, and it's talking about... I see several diets are low fat. One of the most popular ones right now, I think, is probably Noom. I don't think it's Atkins. I forget what the other one is, but there's like two that are pretty much like no fat, low fat. And it kind of struck a chord with me because I'm not necessarily real big on eating fat, but I didn't realize how important it was and how much... It helped me because I eat different now and I do use fat. I just don't, like, I eat avocados and I eat nuts and different things like that. And I don't think I eat, when I first did Trim Healthy Mama, I didn't do that. So I just found it interesting. And I'm not necessarily a big, huge fan of Noom because it's, to me, it just seems like it's a different version of Weight Watchers. And it just does, it's, you still eat junk food. No offense. So I understand that it's nice because you get to, there are no off find foods you can just adjust. And I get that. But I just feel like for myself, I would rather make the sacrifice to have better quality food instead of just eating junk out there. That's just me. But anyway, you can do whatever you want. So anyway, I'm going to read what Serena Pearl talked about. Stripping the fat from all meals causes an imbalance in the body, including loss of lean muscle and more fat gain around the middle. Fat prevents heavy mood swings. It is essential for brain and nervous system function. It keeps skin soft and less lined and is critical for hormone production. Best of all, fat satiates like nothing else. Okay. It gives a warm, nurturing fullness and quiets the cravings. So go fry yourself up some eggs in butter or coconut oil and enjoy a coffee with a swirl of cream. And actually, I have fried eggs and coconut oil almost every week, at least once. So I'm good with that. And I do put cream in my coffee. Well, I don't necessarily drink coffee. I do Dandy Bun, but so I already do all that. I just thought that it was kind of neat how our body really needs the fat, especially for hormones and for nervous and brain function. So it's like, I'm almost completely convinced that the reason my anxiety for certain things is like pretty much completely gone is because I started eating the Trim Healthy Mama way. Because even though I still have some issues, not saying I don't have any, it's easier to talk myself down or to get myself out of that rut, I guess you could call it. But I eat differently now, and I do eat healthy fats. And I can see for myself that it's definitely something, fats are definitely something that my body needs. Because when I do an email, I struggle to feel full. I can fill up on non-starchy veggies. I'm not saying that I can't, but I don't stay full that long. So I can see why when I do an S meal and they call it satisfying, I can see why, because I don't struggle to get to 3 hours with an S meal. I just don't. But an E meal, quite often I'm, you know, grabbing a fuel pull snack because I simply am starving. So, and I do love my E meals, don't get me wrong. I think when I first did Trim Healthy Mama, I didn't do very many emails. I did as helpers, and I would probably do an as helper meal every day or so. And I would do maybe 2 or 3 emails a week because it was usually with fruit. The as helper meals would be with some grains. I would have a slice of toast with my bread or something. So that's just how I made it work for me. But now that I'm older, I'm seeing everybody's like low dairy and probably more emails. I'm thinking, ooh, that could be really tough. That's not something I have done well on. So, but you adjust and you move on. So anyway, that's what I got out of the 100 Days of Inspiration this week. And that's all I got for you. So I don't know where you are in the book or if you've done the book, but I'm going through 100 days. I think I started in January sometime. I think the first Monday in January is when I started. So I'm slowly going through the book. And when I get done with this one, I am going to do I'm That Girl book. So I'm looking forward to that one. I thought it'd be kind of fun to go through chapter by chapter in these books together. Just because sometimes it's like we come flying through the book and do we actually study it and get out what we need? Or do we just read it and not study it? So this time I've been intentional about studying it. The only thing I wish I had done different, I wish that I had gotten myself a highlighter and like highlighted the things in the book that I really enjoyed or really stuck out to me. And I never bought a highlighter. But I may go ahead and get a highlighter for my other book, the I'm That Girl book, because I feel like I don't absorb and keep that information. It would be nice to like flip through the book next year and see how I've changed, like what things means things. I mean, what things stick out to me next year. It'll be kind of interesting. But anyway, thanks for letting me chat on and bore you to death. So I'll see you next time. Bye.